Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to easily create a vintage CRT monitor text effect. This is an update of a tutorial I did quite a while ago on an earlier version of Photoshop. This version is quicker and easier. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl or Command N, or go to File and New. Make the width 1920 pixels, the height 1080 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB color and 8 bits per channel. Click the background color box and pick black. Then click OK and create or open. Open your horizontal type tool. Before we add our text, check your foreground and background colors. If they are not white and black respectively, press D on your keyboard and then press X to invert them. White should be our foreground color so we can see our text easily. Pick a font you'd like to use. I'm using OCRA Extended Regular. If you'd like to use it as well, the link is in my video's description or project files below. Feel free to adjust the size based on the font you pick and the amount of characters in your text. The aliasing is irrelevant since we'll be blurring the text. I'll make its alignment centered. Click on your document and type out your text. To center it on your document, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select the canvas. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. We'll convert our text into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and replace it with different text without having to redo the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Click the FX icon and click Color Overlay. Click the color box to open the color picker. In the hexadecimal field, type in 00FAFF. Then press Enter or Return twice to close both windows. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 60 pixels. To save space in the Layers panel, click the small arrow to collapse the effects. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Open the effects of the copy and double-click Gaussian Blur and make the radius 5 pixels. Collapse the effects and make a copy of this layer. Open the effects of the top layer and double-click Color Overlay. Click the color box and type in C0FEFF. Then press Enter or Return twice to close both windows. Go to Filter, Other, and Maximum. Make the radius between 8 to 10 pixels and the preserve squareness. Next, we'll add two soft scan lines. Close the effects and click the new layer icon. Open your rectangular marquee tool and make sure the Add To icon is active. This will add additional selections as we make them. Drag your tool from one side to the other, making a rectangular selection approximately this wide, and make another one the same size below it. Fill the selections with black by pressing Ctrl or Command plus Delete. This fills them with the background color, which is black. Then deselect it. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 10 pixels. Control-click or command-click the thumbnail of the scan lines to make a selection of their shape. Make the layer under it active, and Alt-click or Option-click the layer mask icon to make an inverted layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Since we have the scan lines as a layer mask, we can delete the top layer by making it active and either pressing the delete key on your keyboard or dragging it into the trash. Press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of the layer mask to the layer under it. We'll convert all of our text effects into a smart object by shift-clicking the bottom text layer and clicking Convert to Smart Object. Make a copy of it and change its blend mode to overlay. Open your Move tool and drag the copy up and to the right approximately this much. The copy is a bit too intense, so let's reduce its opacity to 80%. To finish the effect, we'll add CRT monitor scan lines. Make a new layer. We'll fill it with 50% gray by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the fill window. Click 50% gray. Invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Halftone Pattern. Make the pattern type Line, the size 2, and the contrast 50. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 3 pixels. Change its blend mode to soft light. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.